Mouse. You know, Mickey Mouse? I hope you've heard of me. I hope.
Who's the leader of the club that's made for you and me? M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E. Hey there, hi there, ho there, you're as welcome as can be.
Hello and welcome back to Disney Marvels for week of November 11th, 2018. This is episode 26. Disney Marvels, the show about Disney, Marvel, Lucas, soon to be Fox, Disney Plus, and so much more. If it has to do with Disney, it's fair game. I'm your host, Matthew Graykin. And now, on to the news. It's a light news week, but a very important one. First off, the Walt Disney Company has committed $500,000 to support relief and recovery efforts in response to the wildfires that continue to threaten California. The donation will provide support to firefighters on the front lines as well as they work to contain the fires and will assist California residents during this unfortunate, difficult time. A little more positive news, the teaser trailer for Toy Story 4 is now available to watch. It doesn't really give you much about the about what's going on. It's just a fun, whimsical way. And it also goes to show you, Toy Story 4 trailer is now out before the Avengers 4 trailer. So, just an interesting note there. Fortunately, additional piece of very sad news that it's affected a lot of people around the world. Monday, November 12th, 2018, Stan Lee, one of the main people of Marvel, passed away at the age of 95. The former head of Marvel Comics was the creator of such iconic comic book characters, or co-creator of such comic book characters as the Hulk, Spider-Man, the X-Men, and so many more beloved characters. He was in some ways a personified character himself, larger than life for Marvel, kind of synonymous with the Marvel brand, especially as the movies became a forefront, and just people loved to see him. That's all I'm going to say about him. This week, I will dedicate an episode to him and his legacy in the very near future. Really downer news segment this week. I'm sorry about that, but we will keep it short and on to happier things. So, on with the show.
Close your eyes. Don't peek. I've got a surprise.
As Walt Disney famously said, it all started with a mouse. This November 18th, we will be celebrating the 90th anniversary of that little meek mouse who was looking for a job and found success on the big screen and in Hollywood. Mickey and his wife, yes, you heard me correctly, Mickey and Minnie Mouse are married. And conveniently for Mickey, they share the same birthday. So he will never forget his wife's birthday, which some people do struggle with. I fortunately do not. But if you don't believe me that they're married, listen to this. In a September 30th, 1933 issue of Film Pictorial Magazine, Walt Disney said, and I quote, "In private life, Mickey is married to Minnie. A lot of people have written to him asking this question because sometimes he appears to be married to her in his films and other times still courting her. What it really amounts to is that Minnie is, for screen purposes, his leading lady. If the story calls for a romantic courtship, then Minnie is the girl. But when the story requires a married couple, then they appear as man and wife. In the studio, we have decided that they are married already. Now, this is probably the most secret marriage in Hollywood history. But when it comes down to it, you can honestly think that Minnie would have just hung around waiting for Mickey to ask her hand in marriage for 90 years? Probably not. I mean, come on. How many girls do you know out there are just going to sit there waiting and waiting? I'm like, okay, it's 90 years already, Mickey. You have enough money. What are you waiting for? So, that puts that rumor to rest. But I digress. This week, I really want to celebrate Mickey. After all, Walt was right. If it wasn't for Mickey, would any of what we love so much about Disney exist? Would there even be a Disney company? Or would the Disney Brothers Studios folded after they lost Oswald the Lucky Rabbit to Universal and they finished with the Alice comedies? He popped out of my mind onto a drawing pad 20 years ago on a train ride from Manhattan to Hollywood at a time when business fortunes of my brother Roy and myself were at the lowest ebb, and disaster seemed right around the corner. This is a quote from Walt Disney that he wrote down back in 1948 in an essay titled, What Mickey Means to Me. After not only losing Oswald to Charlie Mintz, a distributor for Universal, he also lost most of his Disney artists as well. This was a very dark time for Walt. He sent a telegram to his brother Roy with when he'll be arriving back, when his train schedule was, and he did not mention the situation that the two of them have now found themselves in, financially and just creatively and just kind of the down point of it. But this is Walt Disney we're talking about, the ever optimist. And he did say one thing to his brother on that telegram, and that was, don't worry, everything will be okay. Not that he had a plan at this point, but that train ride, and I'm sure it felt like the longest train ride of his life to that point. Little did he know that this very moment in his life, he will not only change his and his brother's life, but that of the world. An incredible journey indeed. That sketch that he drew on that train ride, that little idea that was in, it was refined by Ub Iwerks, was to be Mortimer Mouse. And thankfully, like any good man, Walt listened to his wife Lillian and named him Mickey instead. Could you imagine singing along to the Mortimer Mouse Clubhouse March, or Mortimer Mouse Club March, instead of the Mickey Mouse Club March? Can you imagine giving dolls to little children of Mortimer Mouse instead of Mickey, and them crying for Mickey as they run to the characters at the parks, or crying Mortimer instead of Mickey? That just puts an interesting... It's just nothing against the name Mortimer, but it's just not as warm and fuzzy as Mickey has become, or at least now that we think of it. Now, November 18th is the birthday of Mickey, but that wasn't always the case. Originally, the date had moved around depending on what the studio was promoting and what was going on, and just kind of went with the wind, as it was. Walt once said, he was born on October 1st, 1928. That was the date on which the first picture was started. But that date didn't hold for long. It was anywhere from September to December, depending on the promotion, depending on who you talked to. There was no firm date. It wasn't until the founder of the Disney Archive, Dave Smith, declared in 1978... So 40 years ago, this is when we officially got that Mickey and Minnie's birthdays were to be November 18th. The reason for that is because this is the original release date of Steamboat Willie, which was released and marketed and marks the first public appearance of Mickey Mouse. This is when they came out and people went, oh my goodness, this little mouse is amazing. That's also because Steamboat Willie was Mickey's first release, but not his first short. As some people do know, but not many people are aware of this. Playing Crazy was the first short created and shopped around to distributors. The Galloping Gaucho was the second. And neither of them were picked up. They both failed to pique any interest. The main difference between them and Steamboat Willie was the synchronization of sound. That was, as strange as it is now, wherever we could walk around with a little electronic device in our pocket and pull up a video from halfway across the world and watch it with our friends or to ourselves at any point in time that we want. That 90 years ago, synchronizing sound to a film in a theater, in a movie theater, was new and was a novel idea. It wasn't something done before, particularly with cartoons. You know, they had a soundtrack that would go along, but vocal sounds, you know, hearing Mickey squeak and Pete laugh and Minnie squeal as she's running after the steamboat to get on the ship, that was new back then. That was the first of its kind, and Steamboat Willie was that. Playing Crazy and Galloping Gaucho did not have that uniqueness to it. In fact, one distributor even said to Walt, "They don't know you, and they don't know your mouse." And that's a not being there when that was said. Just reading this on paper, that's actually a pretty cold critique. But in frankness, no one knew who Walt Disney was really back then. And no one definitely knew who Mickey Mouse was back then. And this was actually back on May 15th of 1928. So just think, they already produced, they already drew out and created two short films at the beginning of 1928, and Mickey and Walt was still, well, Mickey too, was still facing rejection. And Walt did not give up. And that really speaks to the character of Walt Disney. And as you go through his life, this is something that becomes a common theme of rejection and determination. You know, how many times, you know, you looked at it when he's trying to create Disneyland, when he's trying to get the rights to Mary Poppins, when he is trying to make movies, when he's trying to deal with the strikes at his studio. He's constantly having to face opposition and rejection. And I think that also not only speaks to the character of Walt Disney, but it speaks to the character of Mickey Mouse. And maybe one of the reasons why Mickey is such a humble, lovable little personality is because what was going on at that time in Walt's life, in his personal life, his business life, his family life, his brother's life, and how much they had to they struggled. The economy wasn't just, you know, financially for them, it was the dumps. The economy in general itself wasn't that grand. And Walt persisted. And, I mean, nowadays, someone like that said you're crazy. I mean, granted, you just stick it on YouTube and get a million views and it goes viral, but that's not how things worked back then. I mean, he worked hard for this. He had very loyal employees that I don't know how he was paying them, because they didn't have any income. I mean, their one source of income had been taken from them, and there wasn't many people working for Walt back then even. But there were some people that stuck around. And his close... will recognize that in people. And you do something like that for him, and he knew it. And he found it very special. He did consider it almost family. But on, as we know, November 18th, which is the fated day that the Colony Theater in New York City opened its doors, the world got to meet that Mickey Mouse, whose struggles were the people's struggles, whose humbleness was the people's humbleness. Walt Disney said that Mickey Mouse is a little personality unto himself. And that was key. Until that point, cartoons were saw as something just to laugh at. They were just doing silly things. It was something to just fill the time and lighten the atmosphere before the main picture. Or the newsreel or whatever, because again, we're thinking modern times. It was a lot different back then in theaters. So, and people fell in love pretty quickly. And Walt was paid $1,000 for a 2-week run. Now, granted, 2018, $1,000, well, that's chump change. Especially for something like this. But we're talking 1928. $1,000 was a substantial amount of money. And at that time, it was the highest amount paid for a cartoon to run on Broadway. So that speaks to something. That was the building blocks of what we now know as the Disney Company. I mean, Mickey is a corporate symbol. As Robin Williams famously said in the animation, on the animation attraction in the Hollywood Studios, or Disney MGM Studios at that time, wasn't it? Yeah, Mickey say, yeah, I mean, I don't know, guys, if you remember it, or if you've seen it yourself, where he's doing the little animation thing. It was the little short film kind of talking about how the animation is made, and he turns himself into Mickey Mouse, and he says, oh, I'm a corporate symbol. And that was Robin Williams. But even to this day, 90 years later, people still love Mickey Mouse. Maybe even more so than ever. People still love Mickey Mouse. And he speaks to people. I mean, the kids eat him up. Adults still love him. Still wear... you buy an Apple Watch, you still could get it. It's still... I would consider it a Mickey Mouse watch. You could still have Mickey Mouse on the face of your Apple Watch. Not an additional feature. It comes that way. You know, the t-shirts, jackets, hats, jewelry, expensive jewelry at that, expensive watches. You know, Mickey is still everywhere. And more so than ever. And it's definitely worth celebrating. I mean, 90 years of a character that hasn't faded is still relevant. I mean, there's still new Mickey Mouse shorts being produced. Not, granted, not the same type of Mickey Mouse shorts that were produced 90 years ago. But in some ways, they can be. If you ever go back and watch those black and white Mickey Mouse shorts, they're not necessarily like the ones that I think most people bring to mind, which are the colored ones that they produced in the 50s and 60s. There is a big difference between those earlier Mickey Mouse shorts and the latter ones, where Mickey was more of a backup character that they brought in, or it was him and Donald, him and Goofy. It was not just Mickey. And Mickey was kind of your everyday man, which he still kind of is. But you go back to the black and whites, he was a lot more raw, he was a little more controversial. And, well, in our views now, when some of the stuff they did, it was a little more brash. There was a little bit more of an edge to Mickey in those early black and white days. And I invite you to go back and watch them. But Mickey is, again, something special to all of us. And if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be doing this podcast. People wouldn't be driving to the vacation capital of the world in Florida, Walt Disney World, or Disneyland Park, California, Tokyo, Shanghai, Beijing, Paris. You wouldn't have the parks. You wouldn't have the Disney Channel. You wouldn't have the Disney Store. You wouldn't have all those movies. It all started because of a mouse. Here's to you, Mickey and Minnie. Thank you for everything you've done for people all over the world. So what is your favorite Mickey Mouse cartoon? Short, you know, and the new ones, old ones, whichever ones. You have more than one? That's okay. Trust me, it's hard to narrow down 90 years of history to just one choice. So let me know what your favorites are, or some of your favorite video clips. Share them out on the socials. Put them on the Facebook. The Facebook group is facebook.com/DisneyMarvelsPodcast. One more time, it's facebook.com/DisneyMarvelsPodcast. Or you could use the Twitter if you prefer that. And the Twitter account is @DisneyMarvels. One more time, on Twitter, it's @DisneyMarvels. Or email the show, DisneyMarvels@gmail.com. Let me know that way if you don't use social networking. Or if you have an idea for a show, you could email me at the show as well. Thank you very, very much for spending your valuable time with me. I know how little time we all have nowadays, and knowing that you've spent a portion of it with me means a lot. Remember, no matter what you're facing, the power to overcome it is within you. Don't give up, and you too can achieve greatness. Remember, as I said, all the struggles Walt Disney went through, and he didn't give up. And look what he achieved. And that was, he was in his late 20s at that point. If I could ask two more things of you, though, please. Please share this show with your friends. Tell your friends, tell your family, share it out on Facebook, on Twitter, Instagram, whatever your social network coffee is. Share it out that way. Word of mouth works great too. Email it. Fax it. You know, whatever you do. Send it out. The more people that can join in and we can enjoy this together, the more we can enjoy it together. Also, please take a moment, rate the show on whichever medium you're enjoying it. iTunes, Stitcher, any of the other ones, Breaker, any of the other ones out there. Please share it. Please like it. Please rate it. It does help people actually find the show by rating it. So today, instead of me reading the quote, I think I will have Walt Disney read the quote for you. I think it's only fair and it's only appropriate, being that we're celebrating Mickey's birthday, and all intents and purposes, he is Mickey's father, Mickey's daddy. So, I'll let him do it. So, with that, I'm going to sign off now, and I'll see you next time. Take it away, Walt.
During the last few years, we've ventured into a lot of different fields, and we've had the opportunity to meet and work with a lot of wonderful people. I only hope that we never lose sight of one thing, that it was all started by a mouse.
Congratulations! Shake your hand, congratulations, happy days to you. You sure